Hello, bravs. We're back with another pumpkin beer review, number two of 2024. As you can see, Dogfish Head Craft Brewery has their new pumpkin ale, brown ale with pumpkin. Apparently, I don't know if this can is permanent, but it's the 2024 Art Series. And this gangster-looking pumpkin is a complete fucking farce. But we'll pour it anyway. Illicitly pouring it wrongly. Oh, it's going over the top, bruv. Oh, is it going to go over? No, it did. An absolutely horrid pour. But that's okay. We're good, bruv. I've got a towel behind me. I pour them all equally bad on purpose. You may say it's a false pour, incorrect pour, but that's the way I do them, bruv, to make them equal. Let's get this over here so you can look at the wretchedness of this can. Although, I like the crow, Raven. As craft brewing has evolved, beers like Dogfish Head, which were once considered mainstays of the seasonal excellence, have just become pretty much mediocre, almost, what's the word, macro beers. This beer, to my taste, has deteriorated. I mean, it's almost... almost tastes like a Newcastle Brown at this point. What's that other one? What's the other one? The Honey Brown? Yeah. Negligent pumpkin. It's got a good head on it, though. I'll give it that. Maybe I will create a Black Cat Brewery pumpkin ale. It'll just be pumpkin ale year round. There's a little pumpkin in that taste. Mostly though, it's just a dull brown ale. Dull brown. We brew our culinary inspired beers using real ingredients. Every beer has a story rooted in adventurous flavors and creative brewing processes. Explore the goodness with every sip. A full-bodied brown ale brewed with real pumpkin, brown sugar, allspice, nutmeg, and cinnamon. Enjoy smooth pumpkin and fall spices. This is in collaboration with apparently the Boston Beer Company, which I assume is Samuel Adams. Dogfish Head Craft Brewery, Milton, Delaware. Brinigsville, PA, Cincinnati, Ohio. That must be the one in collaboration with. Yeah, so this is just Macroswell at this point, which is kind of what Samuel Adams has turned into. All of Samuel Adams' best beers are usually the seasonals, like the old Fezziwig. Let's drink more. As it warms, it might increase in flavor. Very bready, very brown, scant pumpkin and spices. I mean, I will grant that it's well mixed, the flavorings, but they're all mostly muted, so. It's a great mix if you just want a boring brown ale, but if you want a pumpkin, like that one I had last night, what was it called? That stuff. I was reeling for 3 hours from that stuff. Very high potency. Man, I don't know if I even give this in the sevens. I think this would be the last year I buy pumpkin ale. As I've said, it's deteriorated every year. Or as I've also opined, maybe it's just the other beers are just surpassing them. And they are static in their goals. Because this is just, like I said, Newcastle Brown. Boring. This is abominable. An abominable art series. I don't know who thought this was a good art. I mean, minus the fucking chain and padlock. Billie Eilish chain and padlock and the fucking arm sleeves of gaudy tattoos. I would give it about a 6 on the art scale. But as is, it's about a 1, negative 100,000. Oh, there's a guitar, too, coming out of his shoulder. Or is it in his, behind his back? It's coming out of his shoulder, bruv. Put myself out of my misery. There it is. The white hole to oblivion of Kraft Macro Swill. I give this a 6.3. And that's pretty generous. 6.3 as a beer. A beer. And about a 5.2 as a pumpkin beer. They've lost their touch. They've lost their way. I may do a re-review just to see if I'm non-plussing myself, but I don't think so. What did I say? 6.3 out of 5.2. I don't know what the hell I said. It's not good. It will finish in the bottom tier of all the reviews. I guarantee you by the time I have the four Elysians and... what is it? The Rogue Pumpkin Patch Ale. This will be number 7. It'll be 7 out of 7. So there you go. Rubbish.